Chess, Go, StarCraft, Jeopardy, Dota. We are now part of the Singularity. The best players in the world have fallen to their AI foes, created by large megacorporations. But why should the megacorporations be able to have all the fun? When the AI overlords take over, I want them to know that I helped. You know, Roko's Basilisk and all that. Oh great overlord, what game may I ruin today? So today, we're going to be making a Smash Bros. AI. The first problem is that I need to actually be able to play Smash Bros. On my computer, but Smash Bros. Is a Nintendo game, and they only make their games for their own special hardware. Luckily, people have created these things called emulators, which can take the code for a Nintendo console and translate it into something that can run on any computer. So I got an emulator and booted up the game, and for fun, I tried to match against the CPU. But I was pretty bad. But the good news is, it doesn't matter how bad I am, because I'm making an AI to play the game for me. Although I must say, throughout this entire process, I kind of got halfway decent. The next step is to get values from the game. At first, I was thinking of using screenshots of the game, then running them through some sort of computer vision algorithm to identify the locations of players. But there was a problem. Do you see how much stuff is happening in this game at once? There's explosions, there's dust, the camera's swinging around at a million miles per hour. It just wasn't gonna work. Then I thought of something better, reading memory locations. When you're playing a game, the game needs to know where you are so it can know where to draw you on the screen. These coordinates are stored in what's called memory. To demonstrate how this works, here I have the game I made for my Team C's video, and we're going to extract information from it using a tool called Cheat Engine. For this, I want to be able to extract my score from the game. To start, I have a score of 0, so I will enter in 0. All of these rows on the left are different memory locations that are currently equal to 0. There are a lot of them, so this information isn't very helpful. However, once I score a few points, I'm able to scan again. Now, all of these rows on the left are locations which were originally 0, however are now 3. Obviously, there are still a lot of them, so let's do one more. Now we're down to only 3 memory locations, so I'm going to pick this first one and call it score. You'll notice it currently reads a value of 4. However, as I score more points, we can see this value gets updated. I now have the ability to extract my score from the game. So if I wanted to do this for Smash, I would need to repeat this process for each character's coordinates, their velocities, their current percent, what action is performed, and so on, and very quickly this becomes very tedious. The good news is, somebody has already done all that tedious work, and you know what they say, roses are red, violets are blue, all of my code was written by you. Thanks, comrade. So before I could go on, I needed a quick test to see if I could actually get my code and the game to interact. So I made this basic example where Fox just tries to move towards an idle character. Now it's time to do the whole AI thing. So when I've made AIs in the past, they've all been what are called genetic algorithms, which basically means there's hundreds of random agents which all act at the same time and the best players get to be cloned, whilst the rest are deleted. However, this approach would not work for this game, as I can only have one agent playing at a time, and it would be very difficult and time-consuming to compare agents against each other separately. So this is where training neural networks comes in. This is a neural network. It takes numbers as input and gives numbers as outputs. These lines in the middle are called weights. Each node is the sum of all the nodes in the previous layer times their connecting weights. So for this very simple neural network, given inputs of 6 and 4, we can find out what the output should be. 4 times 2 is 8, 6 times 0.5 is 3, 8 plus 3 is 11, so this node would be 11. Then we can do the same for the second node in this layer. Then we repeat the process and we get our output of 28. Although this is a very simple example, using computers, we can scale this up to be significantly more complex. However, these weights currently have no meaning and are essentially giving us random outputs. So we need to train this network. To train a network, you first need to know a set of inputs and target outputs. From this data, we can slowly tune the weights to give us better outputs. This is called backpropagation. I'm not actually going to go too in depth about how this actually works because that's all you need to know for this video, but Fellow small coding YouTuber Coffee Break has a very good explanation about it on his channel, link in the description below. If you were paying close attention to what I was just saying, you may have picked up on a key word there. You need target outputs, meaning you need to already know what the outputs should be. This is great if you have a database of human-made decisions and wanted to automate future decisions, but for a task like learning to play Smash Bros, where you're working in uncharted territories, this wouldn't work. So instead of predicting specific values, you have a set of actions like move right, punch, or jump, with each action corresponding to an output of the neural network. For every game state, you have a function that tells you how good it is. So if you deal damage to your opponent, the goodness score is high, and if you walk off the ledge and die, the goodness score is low. Then each output of the neural network corresponds to what the goodness score will be if that's the action taken. Then once the network is trained, the AI performs the action that has the best goodness score attached to it. To train the network, you start off with a bunch of random actions and slowly update what the goodness scores should be. This system is called reinforcement learning. I'm actually using an algorithm called DQN, which is a little bit more complex, but I don't really have the time to go into the subtleties and differences of DQN in this video, but I've linked a paper in the description below for all of you who like having a fun read. Yeah, that's right, I read papers for this video. So I implemented this algorithm and slapped it into the game, and it didn't work. It just resorted to continuously jumping. So I tried changing the reward structure to be based on states instead of actions, jumping. So I tried rewriting my DQN algorithm in PyTorch from Keras in case that's what was causing the issue, jumping. So I tried creating an entirely new AI training algorithm in order to target more short-term rewards, jumping. So I tried to reweight the rewards for actions, jumping. So I completely redesigned the controller code and how the game handles inputs, jumping. Now folks, I've heard of unproductive spirals, but this is ridiculous. Eventually, I gave up and just called my friend. It doesn't work.
You idiot. You are storing the action in a variable called action, but the AI is learning from a variable called self.action. And self.action is never set equal to action, so it's always zero regardless of what the performed action is, meaning the AI will never be able to learn.
Shoot, that's actually a really good point. I don't know how I missed that. Thank you so much.
Maybe next time, you should try getting good. Did you ever think about that, you little punk? That's what I thought. You code bullet wannabe.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer.
I lost like 3 months on this one bug, which is fixed with a single line. I'm actually so done with this project. And after training it, it was actually able to beat the CPU. Just one problem. So yeah, it just found one move to spam and it managed to beat it every time. So from here, I tried a couple things, like changing the training parameters, having the AI train against itself, having the AI train against an opponent that doesn't run into its attacks. But the same problem kept occurring. I started searching for solutions, and I found actual research papers on people training AIs to play Smash Bros. And they all also ran into this same problem. That said, there was actually one paper I found capable of making a good agent. In this paper, they trained on a university supercomputer running 50 agents at once at 5x speed. They trained this model for 8 hours, meaning if I tried this method, it would take me 83 days. And frankly, I don't have that time or that RAM. There had to be a better way. Now, I'm gonna preface this next part by saying the Smash community is absolutely insane. The amount of statistics they collect on everything is overwhelming. Every single animation is analyzed to its core, and players perform complex maneuvers in order to save single frames. This analysis, of course, includes tournament play. Their system set up to record games played on 20-year-old consoles and save the game states on modern machines. However, in addition to game states, these replays also save controller inputs. So instead of training an AI to beat an AI, I can train an AI to just be a pro player. From the controller state, we can figure out the combination of buttons and axis movements being made and create a set of possible actions. We have a neural network where each output represents one of these actions, and we train the network using game states as inputs. Playing as and against different characters requires wildly different styles of play. So each AI will only be able to play as one character and built to play against another specific character. So first, I just filter through the replays to get which character I want to target and extract the game states and controller states from that replay. I can create a function that logs whenever a player performs an action, and I can generate paired values of the game states to the actions. Then I just throw it into a machine learning model. Now, this still has some problems. Mainly, pro players are too good. Because of the way I am training this model, there are only a limited number of controller inputs that the bot can use. Pro players do many things that can't be represented well with these actions, namely wave dashing. With this, the players will jump and press the shield button while angling the input specifically, so they gain slightly faster speed and slightly better hitboxes. Other techniques such as dash dancing, wave shine, and shield drop, along with many others, just aren't feasible to include in this project because of how technical these inputs can be. However, because these actions are so commonly used in professional melee, the AI always tries to do them, leading to subpar results. Yeah, you go, kid. Show the world who's boss. I believe in you. So, to counteract this, I just manually decreased the amount that these actions would be used. Conversely, in Smash, there's something called a recovery, which is how you get back onto stage if you're far away. In these situations, pro players will do some very technical things to get back to stage, and I don't have nearly enough training data to take all of that into account. Instead, for some characters, their recovery is going to be hard-coded. However, on stage, all the logic is up to what the AI has learned. I trained a few models, and I pitted them against the level 9 CPU. But before I show you the results, I just want to ask you to subscribe if you like this video, because doing it allows me to justify the hundreds of hours I spend. Without further ado, onto the AI's first match. Okay, so we have Falco versus Jigglypuff. Falco is our AI, and Jigglypuff is the level 9 CPU.
Looks like it's going to be a very interesting match today, folks. It seems as though Jigglypuff doesn't really know what it's doing. It goes for a nice down smash, or a down throw there, rather. Luckily, the Falco, I don't know why you chose Falco, by the way. What happened to Fox?
I like the Falco down drill thing that spikes.
Yeah, down air. I mean, it's true. Wow, amazing. Was that a dash attack? I've never seen that kill before. Not bad. Goes in for another dash attack.
Oh, that was a... Falco just slid there.
He did slide. Was that a wave dash? What was that?
No, like, it wasn't an intentional slide. It was just... going.
This guy knows how to recover, obviously.
Yeah, he's recovering. He has the shine. Oh, that was...
He's got shine multiple times. He knows how to shine. Jesus. Okay. How to shine cancel, rabbit. What is this? Okay.
Oh, can you get back?
The CPU is also kind of being played by an AI. This is an equal fight.
Computer versus computer.
May the best computer win. Jesus, he spikes.
He just runs up and shines.
Look at those angles. It knows what it's doing.
Oh, it can actually only go 90 degrees or 45 degrees. It has no modularity there.
We got a 4v2. He is destroying this computer. Well, I mean, you know, of course the computer is destroying the computer, but still, it's impressive. Goes for more dash attacks. Got the up air, not up air, up special. This Falco, man.
Can you make it back? No, you can't.
You know what? I would have been impressed if you made it back, but that's understandable.
Yeah.
Not even an SD.
Could he have if he did like the side blink thing?
Yeah, if he side special, he definitely would have made it back. I don't know what it was doing there, but you know what? I'm gonna give it some leeway. It's winning, so who cares? It's all style at this point. Okay, that's still all style. You gotta even the playing field, so it's more interesting.
It's a homie stock, I swear.
The homie stock. He's killing him so badly. You gotta give him a homie stock.
Okay, he AI's up a whole stock.
A whole stop, my god. This is not fair. Already figured out that
Smash. Those attacks were clinking. Jigglypuff's got some good hits in there, but Falco gets a grab off.
Fantastic hits. FD going into subspace right now. What's going on here?
Can you make this one back?
Oh, he cannot. If only he knew how to side special.
He can, and he has sometimes.
Well, look at that taunt. You're gonna let him do that to you, Falco. You're gonna let him do that? No, he's not.
Is that it? Nope. Jigglypuff stays alive for a second longer.
That drill.
And that should be our game. The winner is our AI. Let's go.
Nice job.
And with that, I just want to say thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, and all that fun stuff, because it really does help the channel. And I will see you next time.